starting with the colorimetric estimation of Taffer. This experiment is applicable for colored solutions, and I'm starting with the demo for this experiment. First, we have to take three burettes. First burette you have to fill with copper sulfate, and the second burette you have to fill with the ammonia solution, and the third burette you have to fill with the water. First copper sulfate, second ammonia solution, and third with the distilled water. And next step is you have to take seven volumetric flasks will be there. It will be marked as 5, 10, 15, 20, and 25. And then two more flasks will be extra. One is blank and the other one is a test solution. Even it contains the same copper sulfate of unknown volume. So totally you will have a 7 flasks. First step is you have to draw, for the first flask you have to draw 5 ml of copper sulfate. And for the second, you have to draw 10 ml of copper sulfate. And for the third one, 15 ml, 20 ml and 25 ml. Once again, I repeat, you have to take 5 different volumetric flasks which are marked as 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25. The same amount of copper sulfate has to be drawn. 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25 ml. And then, two more flasks will be there. One is blank and the other one is the same copper sulfate where it is of unknown volume. Step is, first step we have drawn copper sulfate into 5 different volumetric flasks, 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25 ml. Second step is for these 5, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 and also for blank and test we have to add 5 ml of ammonia to all the flasks. Second step is add 5 ml of ammonia to each and every flask, and finally you have to make up the solution with the distilled water and you have to mix well and keep the solutions ready. When you prepare the solutions it will be looking like this. Lower the concentration of the copper it will be light in color, and higher concentration copper solution it will be darker in color. So you have to keep the solutions in order once again. 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25 concentrated solutions of copper sulfate. And blank solution, it is colorless in a color because it does not contain any copper sulfate. And this is a test solution which contains unknown quantity of the copper sulfate. This is about the preparation. Once again, I will tell, we have to take first 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25 ml of copper sulfate. And second step, add 5 ml of ammonia to all the flasks. Third step is make up the solution accurately up to the mark with the distilled water. Mix it well and keep the solutions ready. Then we just have to measure the optical joint density. For that we are using the photoelectric colorimeter. This is a cubetta. In this we are taking the solution and we will be keeping in the knob provided here, and we can choose the wavelength of the, you know, we can choose the required wavelength here. Okay, we need for copper sulfate we are measuring at 620 nanometers. So 620 will not be there, so it will be at 620. We have to choose the required wavelength. So we have to choose 61 in this instrument, which is close to 620, and this is the knob where we are keeping the cuvette. Okay, so first we have to take the blank solution. First take the blank solution. First take the blank solution, wipe it well. Keep it in the knob provided and set the OD for 0. Set the OD for 0. This is the only setup we have to do. We have to take the blank solution in the cuvette, keep it in the knob provided and set the OD for 0. Okay, after setting the OD for 0, you just have to measure the readings for all other solutions. No other setups are there. Set the OD for 0 for blank, then throw out the solution, then take the solutions one by one starting from 5 to 25 and measure the optical densities. Next, I will be taking solution number 1, that is 5. Take the solution 5, wipe it cleanly, and keep it in the log provided, and just measure the readings. Whatever it shows, you just have to write that. Okay. So for 0.5, it's showing the 0.06. Right. So in the same way, you have to measure the optical density for all the solutions. So we'll be getting like this. When we measure the optical density for all these solutions, we'll be getting the values like this. After once the values are recorded, we have to plot a graph. We have to plot a graph of, on x-axis you have to take polymer of copper sulfate, and on y-axis optical density values you have to take. So when we take like this, we will be getting a graph like this. This is calibration curve, which is a plot of body against volume of copper sulfate, and you must get a straight line passing through the origin. Now we have taken 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25. For that we have taken the optical densities. Now one more value is extra. Okay, for test solution we have optical density value. We don't know the volume. Okay, where is the optical density here? In the y-axis. So 0.13, mark it on y-axis. At 0.13 you have to mark. Draw a line to the main line passing through the origin. Then extend it to the x-axis. Wherever it meets, this is the volume of unknown solution. Volume of unknown solution -ml. Okay, volume of unknown solution, which is noted here as V. Okay, so we know the value of V now. We have to take the readings from the instrument for all the solutions 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and at last for a tester. Then plot a graph of optical density against volume of copper sulfate. We will come to know the volume of the test solution given. After once you know the volume of the test solution given, you have to do some small calculations. The calculations include, see here, 1 ml of copper sulfate is equal to 63.55 by 249.6 milligrams of copper. So 4 milligrams of copper sulfate is equal to, because we are working the solution from concentration 4 milligrams. So 4 milligrams of copper sulfate is equal to 63.55 by 249.6 into 4. Okay. So we will get a value here. Okay. That is x. You will get one value, that is x. Okay. If you multiply with the volume of the test solution, you will be getting the final value, that is -milligrams of copper sulfate. -milligrams of copper sulfate per liter you will be getting. Take a graph like this. Model graph will be like this.